Clinton's execution. It sounds like you were there at the military tribunal. Were you there?
No.
Okay, what's your source of information that Hillary was executed as you described here on video to your followers?
First and foremost, a journalist can't disclose his sources by law, so I'm not going to burn a source. I believe your client has actually invoked that privilege as well, if I'm not mistaken. I'm an investigative journalist, and I am protected by the First Amendment to not reveal my source, number one. Number two, this exact story is widely reported across many different outlets across the world.
Where did you get it from?
I just told you.
From who? Can you name a source? Any source?
I'm not going to name my sources. Well, absolutely not.
You said it was...
Don't put me out of business.
It was widely reported where?
Across many different media outlets across the world.
Can you name some of them?
No, I can't. I don't have the list here in my head. I didn't know you were going to ask me, but you're free to research it yourself.
Well, your source for Hillary Clinton's execution... first of all, did that person ask for confidentiality?
Objection.
They don't have to ask for confidentiality to be a source of a journalist. It's not how it works.
Okay.
And yes, they did.
Okay. Did you have just one source for this information?
Objection.
Or multiple sources?
I don't know if I had one source for this particular piece of information. I have multiple sources that give me information that are very close to the actual events that I talk about occurring.
Okay. Can you tell me who authorized the execution of Hillary Clinton?
Donald Trump.
Okay.
I'm sorry. The military tribunal authorized the execution.
But
she
Donald
was put through
But Donald
trial.
Trump was there.
Donald Trump was president of the United States, ordered the arrest via the military, and then presided over the execution.
Okay. Did the Secretary of Defense approve the execution?
I have no idea.
Where did the execution take place?
Guantanamo Bay.
And we've seen Hillary since the end of 2018, haven't we, on television? Or is that a body double?
You see what you think is Hillary on television, but that's not Hillary.
Okay. It's your belief that's a body double?
It is a body double.
Okay. How do you know that?
Because Hillary was executed on December 31st of 2018.
Okay, but you aren't a firsthand witness to the execution, is that correct?
Correct. Ask and answered.
Okay. What other high-level public officials were executed by military tribunals?
Joe Biden.
He was, I think you've broadcast that he was executed for crimes against humanity in 2019?
Yes.
And the Joe Biden that was elected president in November of 2020 is really a body double? You've broadcast that, right?
Yes. A body double and or cloning technology is amazing today. Most people don't know about it, but could also be a clone, but I don't think so because it looks nothing like the actual Joe Biden anyway.
All right. So Mark Esper, he was the Secretary of Defense. Does he know about these executions?
Mark Esper turned out to be a cabal deep state plant. And Mark Esper is a traitor, in my opinion.
Okay. Should be executed?
No, I didn't say that.
I thought you said earlier traitors should be executed.
He wasn't put through trial and he wasn't indicted, as far as I'm aware, unless it's still sealed for anything. If he does get found guilty of a crime of treason, sedition, or crimes against humanity, those particular offenses call for the death penalty, which I support in those cases.
Was Anthony Fauci executed?
I have conflicting information on that.
Okay, have you reported that he will be arrested and tried by a military tribunal?
Yes.
And if found guilty, he'll then be executed?
I'm not the one that controls that, but if he's found guilty of a crime of treason, sedition, or crimes against humanity, those particular crimes, if found guilty, carry the sentence of a death penalty.
Did you report on social media that Governor of California Gavin Newsom was arrested and executed?
I believe I reported that Gavin Newsom killed himself.
Okay, and who's standing in for Gavin Newsom now, body double?
Or a clone.
Or a clone. Did you report on social media that the COVID vaccines were developed by Big Pharma to control the minds and actions of humans by way of the 5G networks operated by the phone companies?
I believe that I had discussed that particular topic on my live streams. I don't, in the way that you're phrasing it, did I report on it? In my mind, you're making it seem like I gave that information, but I believe I was corroborating with other truther or citizen journalists, whatever you call us, on that particular set of intel. But
did you report that the COVID vaccine is about the cabal controlling the minds and actions of humans?
I most likely have said those words, yes.
Did you report on social media that there's really a second secret constitution of the United States?
Yes.
And did you report that the Supreme Court of the United States has already rendered a decision overturning the 2020 election?
Yes.
And they just haven't gone public with it yet?
Correct.
Okay. Have you reported on social media that Donald Trump is still the president of the United States, even though Biden or his body double was inaugurated?
Yes.
Did you report on social media that John McCain was one of the first ones put to death by a military tribunal?
Yes.
And you believe that to be true?
Yes.
Did you report on social media that former Governor Andrew Cuomo is a pedophile who raped and killed and tortured children?
Yes.
Did you report on social media that there was no shooting at the concert goers at Mandalay Bay in Las Vegas?
Yes.
Did you report on social media that Donald Trump has control over all banks worldwide?
I don't recall that.
Did you report on social media that Trump sat down with Saudi Arabia in 2017 once he came into office and got control over Saudi Arabia, then Israel, and then the Vatican?
The way that you just said it, no. I did report on Trump's, quote, world tour in 2017. The way that you just said it is inaccurate, but yes.
Well, give me the accurate version then.
Donald Trump, immediately upon taking office, met with, and this is documented if you go back and look at his itinerary, met with several countries, Saudi Arabia being the first, Israel being second, the Vatican, the royal family, China, Brazil, and several other countries throughout the world.
And what did he do? He said, I've got the goods on you. I know you're cabal, you're child trafficking. What did he tell them?
Not necessarily that way, but he had evidence of certain proponents of government that were within government that were doing crimes against humanity. They were committing crimes against humanity. And Trump, and not just Trump, but Trump and his administration, Pompeo, and several military generals who always accompanied Trump, showed them the bad eggs of their own government and asked for capitulation with their governments to help bring down this worldwide ring of terror, so to speak.
The cabal.
The cabal.
Okay. What is the cabal? What's your definition?
The cabal is a global group of elites, such as high-ranking government officials, high-ranking CEOs and presidents of companies, central bankers worldwide, and other financially well-off billionaires that control the world without any of its citizens knowing.
And you said on social media many times Tom Hanks was a pedophile?
Yes.
And is Tom Hanks deceased now?
Yes.
He was executed?
Yes.
And was it a military tribunal that executed him too?
I believe so.
Okay. How many people have been executed by way of the military tribunal? Is it hundreds of people or thousands?
I have no idea.
Okay. Did you report on social media that the District of Columbia has been under martial law for several months and the Patriots blew up the tunnels underneath the District of Columbia, which were used for child trafficking?
Yes.
And you believe that to be true, correct?
Absolutely.
And who's your source for that information?
Asked and answered. I don't give up my sources for journalism.